Welcome to LoyalTV. We invite you to be our guest in the mansion of the father of Oklahoma City.
I think Henry Overholser would be most proud to see how Oklahoma City has evolved. He arrives here back in 1889, already a very wealthy businessman, to basically a tent city, and he just basically starts building Oklahoma City. I'm sure he had no idea that Oklahoma City would eventually spread to over 600 square miles. I think he would be very proud to see how his dream just come through and then some. I love to watch my visitors when I bring them through the doors, and immediately they just stop in place just to take in the beauty of this home. In 1903, when this beautiful mansion was built, it was complete with electricity, indoor plumbing, radiator heat. It has 7 fireplaces, 6 bedrooms, 19 closets, and 109 windows. Now, the carriage house, not only did it house the carriage, it was later a garage, but it was a full-on barn where cows and chickens once were housed along with the horses. This is the first mansion built in Oklahoma City and the first house built here in the Heritage Hills neighborhood. The last time it was occupied was back in 1959, and that was the year the only daughter of Henry Ann Overholser passed away from cancer. The daughter's husband, David J. Perry, becomes the sole heir and would in turn convey the home to the Oklahoma Historical Society in 1972. We always say he basically handed the keys over and walked away because he leaves all the contents in it. It has all the original carpetings, furniture, clothes are still in the closets, books are still on the shelves, and all of these items are for visitors to see when they visit us. I bring our visitors through the receiving area of the home where the lady of the house would have her visitors wait. And as she would come down those grand stairs, she would receive her guests from the receiving area and most likely would ask them to join her over in the withdrawing room. In that room, we still have the original English carpets, the furniture which was furnished in the home in 1903. The next room is the music room, which features Mrs. Overholser's 1902 Kimball piano. The lighting in both of those rooms are brought in from Italy, and all of these rooms are original. Then the room behind me, we call it the smoking room. It features Mr. Overholser's dragon chairs along with his griffin tables. These pieces of furniture were purchased in Chicago at the 1893 Columbian Exposition. And at one time, there must have been a bench that takes the place of this green sofa behind me, because the bench is still in the home, except it does not look very comfortable. The beautiful feature about the smoking room is it still has its original pocket doors. The dining room has all of Mrs. Overholser's china. It is a beautiful room, and I can tell you, there's a photo in front of the dining room which was taken in 1926, and it features Mrs. Overholser. Her daughter is seated at the head of the table, and it must feature her chafing dish club, which she formed back in 1899. And you can see from that photo in 1926, everything from that photo, when you look at the room today, everything is still there pretty much in place. And that's what really makes this home so remarkable. It is an Oklahoma City gem for sure.
Explore more of the best Oklahoma stories you've never heard here on LoyalTV.